If you were going to fire him, and the general sense was that it seemed like he was going to be fired at the end of the year anyway, once everything hit the fan last week and the whole world got really upset with the way Eli was treated, why not fire him then?
Well, I know everybody seems to point to that, but that really ended up not being a factor in today's decision. It was really more of a case of being 2-10 and things falling apart on us, and understanding that we were heading in that direction anyway. So why not do it now and not prolong the agony? You know, you can pick the week. You know, what week do you want him fired? I mean, some people wanted him fired many weeks ago. Others wanted him fired now. Some said wait till the end of the year. Our decision, after I spoke with Steve this morning, was let's not prolong the speculation any longer. Let's get it done today.
And that's all well and good, but again, my question comes back to your organization was painted in a bad light in handling an iconic player in your franchise's history, and you could have solved all that because they were 2-9 before they lost to the Raiders. So you could have solved that by saying, listen, I don't like the way this was handled. I'm going to fire you, and Eli's going to start on Sunday.
Well, yeah, I could have done that, but I chose not to do it. And listen, I'm going to accept the responsibility for that because Ben made a decision that he thought was in the long-term best interest of the franchise. Jerry Reese signed off on it and agreed to it. I agreed to it also with the hopes that when I got back into the office, I could sit down and talk to Ben and get him to ease up a little bit on there being a predetermined time as to when Eli was going to come out of the game. My hope, as I said to the media last week, was that, you know, we'd be playing well, Eli'd be playing well, and we would just leave him in there, as opposed to saying, you know, you're coming out at the end of the half, sort of like it was a preseason game or something. Well, you know, by the time that all happened, he had spoken to Eli. Eli, you know, rejected the notion of coming out at halftime, rightfully so, I think, especially after I was able to sit down and talk to him and hear his side of the thing. So at that point, it was too late. But I don't blame Ben for that. I don't think it was, in looking back on it, it was given everything else that had gone on, it was not the right decision. But it was a decision that he made thinking it was in the best interest of the franchise. So I was not going to kill him for that. The reason for making these changes is more about the state of the franchise and being 2-10 and seeing where we were headed. There were a lot of factors, and just trying to get a little bit of a jump start on whatever we have to do for next year.